You see a red light? It's recording.
Okay.
That's so. Say hi.
What's up?
Sweet.
Here we are, live at the Rodizio headquarters. Man, you know what? We don't let the weather get us down. It's snowing in the background. And here we are tonight to have this barbecue battle. We've got over here that we flew in. We've got a man. We've got Status Q straight out of Fisherville, Tennessee. And also, tonight, we have the Carson Crusher. Man, this is going to be a battle of the grilling minds. Can you believe what we're about to do here? You know what? It may be freezing, but we are about to get it on, ladies and gentlemen, from a grilling perspective that you've never even seen before. We've got Status Q against the Carson Crusher, and we will see who will be the champion tonight.
Let's get it on!
Here we are, gentlemen, at the coin toss. Fisherville, you get to call it. Heads or tails?
Heads.
Heads it is! Fisherville, Status, old Status. Which side are you gonna pick?
I'm gonna take the left lane.
All right.
I believe it needs to be mesquite wood.
We're gonna use mesquite wood.
Mesquite wood and our recipe.
And what's the recipe gonna be?
We're gonna do chicken wings. We're gonna do beanie weenies, and we're gonna do some spare ribs.
Well, that sounds like a challenge, boys. Here we are. Let's get it on.
My first time digging the bacon. This right here is an old Indian trick. Call this a spiral roll. My grandpappy taught me this trick. He's full blooded Cherokee.
The Carson Crusher. Skewering his first spare rib. What are you throwing on there?
Cherry bomb, Don Marcos.
Old Status, what are you throwing on there?
Just a little salt, pepper, not much. Had to start over. Totally forgot about the burnt seasons and the heat of the battle. Cheek keeping them gloves on his side now.
Let's keep it clean, boys.
Oh,
that's a nice skewer there.
Yeah. Somebody played a trick on me. Sabotaged my toothpick dispenser.
He fell for it.
Sabotaged my dead burn toothpick dispenser.
I bet you wish you had a skewer right now.
Nah, I don't need no damn skewer. Yeah, what happens if you're somewhere you ain't got your skewers?
Yep, creep, babe.
You got improvise. You got toothpicks?
Yep.
If I give you toothpick, you gonna give me a skewer?
Yeah.
Well, I don't need that mess.
You don't need one now?
I don't need no skewer.
Bitch.
hit that bomb down there. I don't want to get raw chicken on it.
In honor of Adam Pace, brilliant idea, millipede night. Oh, I'm working that camera.
Millipede night.
Making a mess, lady. We're making a mess.
What you doing with those beanies over there?
A little cherry bomb, that's all we got. But status grill don't rotate them.
There you go.
He throws them on the green.
There you go.
Is that all you have for barbecue stuff?
Yeah.
Sabotage, I tell you.
Those wings look good on that skewer.
Thanks, MC.
Wait till they see what my wings look like on this grate over here.
Woo!
Technique. He does that ball before I do a handspring.
Old Status getting his wings ready. What you up to?
We're gonna see if we can get a little assistance from this bacon. I have my fire going back here. Stir these beanies around.
Any of those beanies falling through?
Not a damn one yet.
You gonna like flipping those by hand?
No, not really.
The battle has begun, boys. The meat is on the grill.
Oh, lost a beanie!
We got a beanie weenie down. Beanie weenie down. Old Status had to take his grill off. His grill grate. Ladies and gentlemen, they're reheating.
Hey, dude, close the bottom. Shit. I told you there's nothing on the fucking bottom.
It wasn't clear about it.
It's suffocating the fire, but I'll close it.
Well, the pan's over there. You want it?
Where?
Put that coal out. Step on it. Put beer on it, something. It's over there.
Headquarters of Carson Rodizio going up in flames.
That's a nice fire there, Bob.
Status, what you getting your foil out for?
There. Getting burnt!
Still burning.
Bam! Bam! Somebody using my dead burnt tongs. Now they're covered in ash. I got beanie weenie fires. I got chicken wing fires. Ah! Here. Get over here, son of a bitch.
Those beanies are hard to handle.
The beanies are hard to handle. But don't worry about it, old status. Got it under control.
Status, you got those ribs wrapped in aluminum?
Yeah, man. I gotta keep that moisture in somehow. Alright. Suffocating.
Do they right here? Close them?
Good and black and dark now. I ain't got no airflow.
Go get your goddamn pan, Bob.
Sadness, you look like you're working. Crusher, you look like you're playing.
Hard. What I do is what I do.
Beanie's coming along nice. The battle continues.
I'm about ready here in a minute. But no one chicken. See, you can see through that hole. Looks good though.
Sure does.
Get up in there, Bob. A little spotlight action there. See that right there wrapping that aluminum? Nothing but goodness in there. That's the price. We'll have to wait on that. Back on, I got a bait.
Looks like we're coming to an end, gentlemen. Status, what you doing?
checking, make sure we're cooked thoroughly.
What's that, a wing?
It's a wing. Nope. That right there will kill somebody.
How you make chicken salad out of chicken feathers. We had 2 pounds of wood, each of us. We were both making our fuel source last, basically working on what little that we had because the stores were closed and we couldn't get out, so we had to make do with what we had. So that's why we only have a limited amount of protein and a limited amount of coal, i.e. mesquite wood chips. This is how you make a cook last with limited fuel. See what happens. I can tell that's some cool music. All right, kind of cool. Whatever.
Oh yeah.
Look at this guy. Look at him.
I'm saving it. I'm ready.
Hold on.
It's ready, but I gotta save it. I gotta keep warm.
Here we go. So, try to get on that mic. I'm trying to shoot the olive oil, let it slide down underneath the coals, and then it fires it back up around the meat. Just gotta make it up as you go. But it's working, so why not? See that? Kind of cool.
Yeah, do it on this side.
How you doing, Drew? Look at him go.
Status quo.
About plate time. Getting in there?
Yeah.
Three!
Yeah.
All right.
Hold on, wait.
Looks really good.
Get down here.
Huh?
Get down here.
Down there?
Step, be careful.
Yeah.
And watch the cord.
Yep.
Yeah, get down here. And pull it back.
My shit's overcooking.
Get us both. Okay. Plate your shit. Like, get plate time.
All right.
Char on them beanies.
Look busy.
Oh, dropping beanies left and right. Hot doggy.
How you doing, boy? Try one.
Ah! They're off the grill, boy. What the hell is wrong?
How them weenies?
Those are what you call good weenies. A little char. Leave that one off.
First one to plate wins. That was good.
Ooh, look at that. Look, that tells you right there how much juice I lose. Look at what's swimming in that. And that was in this pool, was what, in it for 10 minutes?
He's so good. Oh my God, I can't believe he flew him in from Fisherville. We got a low budget in this shoot, but you know, you gotta bring in good talent. Look at that, get in there, ball. Light that shit.
I don't got room for that. All right.
Get my side. Can you back up? Now go ahead and back up, get some long shots. And get you in it and talking to us. Like put the camera up there to get
I know these tripods are too wide now.
I got you. I know what you're working with here, big guy.
Alright, you want me to turn it off? Yeah, it's slippery.
That's what I said.
That is ice.
I know.
That's frozen.
Yeah. I don't know if it's going to stand up there. Because, I mean, that's living on the edge, bro.
Living on the edge.
No way. It's
time to taste and see what we got. So here we are.
Where are we?
I don't know.
Are we here?
I guess.
I mean, you know.
All right, it's go time, baby. Go, get him.
All right, it's go time.
Test it. Say, meanwhile, Blake is letting his stuff stay warm while you judge his, because he wants to make sure you get a...
Looks like the Carson Crusher is waiting to plate.
He's got his work cut out for him, I'll tell you that.
All right, Q, what do we got?
Straight off the grate. We did a little aluminum foil wrap, save on a little bit of our moisture, and it looks like we retained that moisture. It was some work, but nonetheless, the job is done. Now it's up to you to put that in your mouth and swallow it down your gullet. Tell me what you think.
We're starting with the spare rib.
You pick. I don't care, man. There's your knife and fork.
All right.
Or if you want to cut with that, I don't care. You just pick it up and bite into it. Ain't nobody touched it. It's all you.
You need a napkin? You mind getting him a napkin?
Let me go get some napkins.
Spare rib seems kind of moist. Seems like it should be pretty good.
Talking to that.
Spare rib looks like it's moist. Should be good. I think he wrapped it in the aluminum. Let's go in for a taste and see how it is. All right. Fisherville brought it. It's tasting pretty good.
All right, going to the next one. Cut.
Joke.
Is it hot? Joke. Are you serious? Oh my God, help him!
I thought that was pretty funny though. Oh my God, I just choked on him. It didn't cook very well.
That shit's raw.
Holy shit.
Hey, come on. Keep it above the belt.
All right,
taste everything else.
All right.
And I'll be over here.
All right.
I'll be up here filming, waiting. I don't want to have.
Get all a little crispy this.
Let me get in there. So.
A little char on that end. It got a little crispy, I ain't gonna lie. But they're pretty tasty.
Is it good? Dry?
It could stand to be. I should have pulled it off.
Let the judge.
Let's try. You got this little bacon wrap chicken thing you got going
chicken
on here.
Chicken strip, something. Yeah.
Did you keep that heat at a certain temperature there, Q?
No, it's all by feel. You know, just let it ride.
So you've been there, done that, and you just know how it's
rodeo.
Done.
This ain't my first rodeo.
I hear you. Let's taste that thing. All right. A little on the dry side.
What is it?
It's a little on the dry side.
Yeah.
But let's go in for that wing. All right, you're doing all right so far. Let's go in for one of those wings.
Crisp on.
It's got a little crisp on the outside. Let's get in for a little taste. Juicy, good. I mean, crisp on one side, not so crisp on the other, but tasty nonetheless. All right, status. Well played, well played.
Thank you.
Let's see what the Carson Crusher has to offer.
All right. I feel like I'd do the nice, gentlemanly thing in any heated battle and let... I'm coming. And let my opponent go first, because he needed to, because if he went any longer, dry out. But meanwhile, I can just coast and play what I want, and we can wait a little bit, or we can play now.
We can play now?
All right, let's play now.
Well, the Carson Crusher talking a little trash to old Fisherville over there. Status is getting after it. He said that he can leave it on as long as he wants, and it's still going to come off nice and moist. Let's see what the Carson Crusher has to offer. What you got coming up?
Weenies!
So you just let that thing spin in there, and
that's
they just...
it. Take it out like that.
They just cook?
That's it.
So they're not all over the grill, they're all in one spot.
I just want to show this for you, Judge. It's on me. I just want to show you, make sure you see how evenly cooked that is.
Oh, I see the crispness.
Alright.
Yeah. Absolutely.
Let me get you to try one.
Yeah, let me taste one of those. Well, just right in the mouth, I got. Right in the mouth.
Too hot.
Right out of the tumbler and right in the mouth. That's pretty tasty. I ain't gonna lie.
Did you just put your weenie in my mouth?
Look at that.
Good taste. Good cook.
I don't think you ate two of my weenies.
I even went in for seconds on this time. I ain't gonna lie, Q's was a little crisp. All right, here we are with the bacon-wrapped chicken.
Oh, winner.
Looking like it's slicing to some moist perfection here. The Q's was a little dry. This one looks like it kept a little bit of that moisture in there. Let's go in for a little taster. Absolutely perfection, my friend.
Yeah, baby. Turn it on, burn it, bring it, don't sing it, baby.
Very moist, very good. Well played, sir.
You ready for the next one, sir?
Absolutely. Bring it on. What do we got next?
Chicken wings.
We got chicken wings on the plate.
Is that right there?
They look like they got a nice little uniform crispness to it. The Q's, I'm gonna say.
Get up in there.
Looks like it's got a nice uniform crispness to it. The Q looks like sitting on that grate. Just kind of cooked one side, but let's go in and see the taste test. See what we got here. Oh, that is excellent. Uniform crispness all around. Moisture still inside. Tastes good. Very good.
Good game, Coach.
I can't tell you how fire that shot looks right there with the steam rolling off of that thing like that. It's like he's eating it. It's a smoking wing.
Smoking. What do you think?
All right, rip time. Let's see what the ribs you got.
You're gonna need to plate one too, though, like just to get the shot, so that it's a full plate. You know?
Yes.
she'll never, never, never part. Stones from my enemies, these words they were meant, but I cannot survive. The roses from my friends, oh.
Onto the spare rib.
Oh, I cannot survive.
Smell that, Judge?
Oh, he's cutting in. Oh, look at the juice is rolling out of that thing. I can't wait to get my mouth on that.
It's so unfair, motherfucker. We do this because we. It's so unfair, motherfucker. Fall that shit. Fall that shit. Fall it. Fall it, cover it, double bag that shit. That's for you, sir.
Oh, there's the shot right there.
You ready?
That's the money shot.
That's the money shot.
I wish I. Let me get you a paper towel.
Yeah, just cut it. I'll cut it off.
I want you to hold it.
In your rib.
Get him to eat that.
You ready to hold that?
Yeah, on the skewer.
Look at that tasty goodness. Let's sink our teeth into that. Carson Crusher.
Yes,
coming out of the gates firing. I ain't even gonna lie.
Smoky.
That is so tender, so juicy. Nice little crisp on the outside, juicy on the inside. Eating it right off the skewer.
I think this competition was one-sided.
It absolutely was one-sided.
Son of a bitch.
Q, you were doomed from the get-go, brother.
His name is Status.
I was baited.
Old Status. I'm sorry.
So, no. Honestly, what do you think?
Honestly?
Be real.
Honestly?
You saw everything. We both struggled with fire.
Yeah, y'all both struggled
this
with fire.
Real.
What, this was a real cook-off?
Yeah, I was doing everything I could. No joke.
I was doing everything I could to salvage this as well, but we had no fire. Both of us had no fire.
Yeah, then we refired.
Gentlemen, the times... We're tough out there.
We're gonna do one here, and you're gonna hold up a hand. But I want to get genuine commentary from you. Then you can look back and we're narrating it there. And be like,
I mean, clearly my chicken was dry.
Genuine commentary. I mean, honestly, the thing is that.
I mean, I took a bite of my own chicken. I was looking at Blake, going, "It's dry.
It's dry."
Yeah.
That's because you keep it on that one side.
Yeah, so. There's nothing you can do about that. It's be a master
having
at flipping.
Having it turn, honestly, I mean, and honestly, like, you can do whatever you want to do. This keeps
the technique.
It keeps everything, the flavor in, the way that you cook. Like, I mean, honestly, it's ridiculous. The two are, I mean, the being able to put the foil on the spare ribs, like, that helps you out with the juice, you know, a little bit.
Right.
But overall, I mean, the wings were done on one side.
Right.
Beanies were done on one side because you can't like flip it.
You can't. Yeah. Oh no.
Keep that temperature going.
Right. Oh no. No. I knew. I know when you cook chicken. I've told Blake this before. When you cook chicken on a grill, when you're flipping on one side, you have about a 2-minute window of when it's perfect, and you better nail that window. And that's coming down not only knowing the meat, the thickness of it, and the grill you're cooking on, and not only the grill you're cooking on, the flame that you have in it. You know, my point is, oh, I know.
Still not overdone.
I know I've cooked the hell out of some chicken on a grill, and there are times I've nailed it perfect. But it's watching it, it's being on top of it, and it's never consistent like it is on the rotisserie.
It is way more consistent.
Oh, yeah. Money.
You see why we sponsor the Mixed Barbecue Arts Challenge?
Absolutely.
You know, they approached us and we were like, we'd love to. Oh man, I can't believe you thought of us. That's so great.
That's a damn good spare rib.
kosher salt, curry bomb. That's it. And of course,
the equipment's the winner.
What?
Yeah, it is.
I mean, really, I know we're doing all this for fun, but this is some serious shit happening right now.
It is. For real.
You know?
It is some serious shit.
It's probably got shards of metal in it, so be careful when you're playing like you're wiping your eyes.
I'm actually going to honor that he gave me a heads up. Normally he wouldn't say anything. I'd be like,
it's
my God.
It's just wood shavings. Sweaters.
There's metal in mine. He'd be like, oh yeah. I'll like use that to wipe up like 30
all
pounds
right, let's
of
finish this.
Alright.
The food's been prepared. The grills have been fired up. The meat has been cooking. We've plated it, and it is absolutely fantastic, motherfucker. All right, here we go. The food has been prepared. The grills have been fired up. The meat has been cooking. We've plated it. We've had a taste test, and we're here to announce who the winner is of this battle royale of the grilling minds. We've got in the beanie weenie competition, we've got Status Q, we've got Carson Crusher, and I'm gonna have to say that this round goes 10-9 to Carson Crusher.
Yeah!
The beanie weenies. They were a little crisp, Q. They were a little crisp.
They were a little crisp. I see.
Here, man, this helps me out.
I see.
This helps me out. It's a crying towel.
It's a crying towel.
I've been wearing it out for a long time now. I think you could use it because you just got your ass kicked, baby.
In all honesty, we've come here to see Q, the status, come against Carson Crusher. And honestly, the Crusher takes the cake. 10-9. There's just something about the way that was cooked, the moisture that it kept, and honestly, it beats conventional grilling all day long.
I would like to thank our sponsors, Carson Rodizio, for supplying the equipment that allowed this challenge to happen, and it's all in fun. It's all in fun, but
the Rodizio wins.
He took the words out of my mouth. Thank you, sir. Thank you. Yeah! Woo! See, I love the towel throw. I can use that. This is what we ended on the last video. Jack Johnson at the end.
Oh yeah.